Welcome everyone to the FinFO Cloud in the Field. Just a quick reminder, if you are not a subscriber to our channel, make sure to follow the AKA link below. This is the AKA link for the playlist with all the episodes that we release on the FinFO Cloud in the Field. And thank you very much for your audience. Today we have a very interesting topic, which is an area that we are investing more and more related to containers. So is the scope is defender for containers. And no one better than that to talk to us about this than our friend from our Israeli team, Tomer Spivak. Tomer, thank you very much for being on.
Thank you, Yuri.
All right, Tomer. So give us a quick overview about what you do in the defender for containers.
So generally, defender for containers, we help our customers protect their containerized workloads, whether it's posture management, which includes hardening for Kubernetes clusters, Kubernetes workloads, and registries, as well as threat detection for containerized workloads.
Awesome. Containers has been growing a lot, and we've been evolving the feature capabilities. But I would like to start this discussion talking about some scenarios. And the first scenario that I'd like to cover is about ECR. So let's say I'm using an ECR. How can I use Defender for containers to perform vulnerability assessment for image in ECR?
That's a very good question, because a few months ago, we released a new capability currently in public preview that enables our customers to protect their container images in ECR. And it's as easy as it is to protect your container images in ECR as it is in Azure. Basically, you need to enable vulnerability assessment for your container images in AWS once. You do this using the Defender for Cloud AWS connectors. So you can either create a new connector or use an existing connector that is already there. And to make sure that you would be able to enable us to scan your container images in ECR, you basically need to enable vulnerability assessment on that connector. Once you enable it, you need to go through all the steps of the wizard and complete it and give us the required permissions in AWS. And this is pretty much all you need to do to enable us to do the scanning in ECR.
Okay, that's pretty cool. So just to make sure that people are aware, when we talk about ECR, we are talking about AWS environment, which means that we need to have the AWS connector set up first. Okay, so that's a very important point. If you don't have the connector, you will not be able to reach those resources. Now, will I need to make any change to configuration when new repos or images are added, or will new regions are used, or it will catch automatically?
No, so a very important part for us was to provide this offering as with minimal efforts for our customers. Once you do the initial enablement, that's pretty much it. Any new repository that you would create on your ECR clusters, regardless of which region, any new image that would be created there would be automatically scanned, and the result would be available within Defender for Cloud.
And talking about scan, Tomer, can you clarify when the image will be scanned?
Yes, of course. So, as part of the existing public preview, we support scanning when the image is initially added into ECR, as well as rescanning all the images 90 days after the last push. For 90 days after the last push.
Okay. All right. This is a little bit different from what we do in Azure.
Correct. So today in Azure, we are scanning images when they are push to a registry and when they're pulled to a registry. We are also rescanning them if they have been pulled during the last 90 days. If they've been pulled during the last 30 days, or if they are currently running on a Kubernetes cluster that we are monitoring using our agent. With our current coverage for ECR, we will continue to rescan images twice a day after they've been pushed, regardless if they are currently running or pulled, basically providing a better refresh time for the vulnerability assessment, which obviously we are also planning to do in ACR in the future.
And I'm assuming that we will see the results of those scans for ECR using the same approach that we use to see the scan mm-hmm. for Azure. Is that correct?
Correct. So we are providing a single pane of glass for all of our vulnerability assessment. Everything is available within Defender for Cloud as a recommendation that shows all the findings that we found for each image that has been scanned.
All right. Do you have to pull any image out of the account to perform this scan?
No. So it was important to us to provide this capability to our customers while making sure that both their intellectual property and their privacy is being maintained. To do that, we have to basically deploy some compute within the customer account. And that basically enables us to download the image locally, pull the image locally within the customer account, create an inventory for the image, and what we are sending back to our backend only includes the metadata of the software inventory without actually taking the images out of the account.
All right, that's very important. And with that, you honor region and everything, right?
Correct. So in addition to scanning the image, creating the initial inventory within the customer account, even when we send the metadata out, we obviously make sure that this is being done within the same region where the repository is located in.
Excellent. Well, let's go through the demo. I think you have some demo to show, right?
Correct. All right. So first, I'll start with onboarding. In terms of onboarding, customers can need to navigate to environment settings under Microsoft Defender for Cloud, and you can either create a new connector for AWS, or you can use an existing connector that has already been created in the past. Regardless of which of the options you are following, when you get to the section where you're choosing the plans, you need to make sure that vulnerability assessment for containers is enabled. We are actually enabling this by default today. So if you are creating a new connector, this should already be enabled. But if you had a previous connector that was already there and you just want to enable vulnerability assessment for containers, just open that connector like I did right now, go to the settings section, and change the toggle for vulnerability assessment from off to on. Once you do that, you need to save this change. Complete all the steps of the wizard again, because obviously you have to give us the required permissions to your AWS accounts when you do this. And following that, we will be able to deploy the required resources within your AWS account and make sure that all your container images are automatically scanned.
All right. So when it comes to see the results, what are the results going to show up?
Okay, so in order to see the results, what I'm doing, I'm navigating back to the main screen of Defender for Cloud, going into the recommendation sections. And what I can see here, alongside the existing recommendation for ACR, I can see a new recommendation for Elastic Container Registry. Once I open that recommendation, I'll be able to see all the results for all the images that have been scanned. We are not showing the registry itself like we are doing in ACR, because unlike Azure, in AWS, there is the service itself, and there is only just a single instance of ECR. But we basically go to the next level of hierarchy, which is the repository. And we are showing here all the repositories that have been scanned with the AWS account where they have been scanned, and the region of that AWS account. For each of the repositories that have been scanned, you can see directly from this view how many vulnerabilities of each type was detected, going from unknown to critical based on the CVSS severity. You can also see the repository that has the most amount of vulnerabilities, the total vulnerabilities, and in total, how many of the repositories that have been scanned are healthy and how many of them are unhealthy. If I go to each one of those repositories, if I dive down to the next level, I'll be able to see each and every one of the images that have been scanned. I can click on that image and get the full vulnerability report that includes the severity, the summary of the severities per vulnerability that was detected, as well as detailed information of each vulnerability that was detected as part of the vulnerability scan.
And which vulnerability assessments engine are we using to scan those images?
So in the case of the existing public preview, we are using the preview open source to perform the scan. This is different than the existing scanner that we are using in Azure, which is Qualys. In the future, we are planning to work on that so customers will see results using only a single scanner.
That's awesome. Thank you very much, Thomas, for demonstrating that. Any final consideration or call for action that you like customers to do as they go through this public preview?
So first of all, I really encourage, if you have images in ECR, I really encourage you to go and enable this functionality. We are currently providing it at no charge, so you'll be able to experiment with it and see the value that it brings, both in how easy it is to get the vulnerability assessment, as well as the value of the scan report itself. And obviously, you'll be able to see to have a centralized location to see vulnerabilities both from your ACR registries and ECR together.
Excellent. And also, just a reminder that as you go through the public preview feature and you test, and if you have any feedback, there are options in the UI for you to provide the feedback, but you can also use the user voice. I'm going to put the link here. The AKA link for the user voice, so make sure to share your thoughts. The team, Tomer and his team, is really eager to hear from you if you have any feedback.
Thank you, Yuri.
All right, everyone, that's a wrap for today. Thank you again, Tomer. Appreciate you coming over and sharing this news. Hope to see you more often in the show. It was really hard to get you here. You're super busy. But good to have you here finally.
Thank you. I really hope that we'll have a chance to record another session.
Absolutely. All right, everyone. Thank you again for our audience. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. This year, we have a lot of things coming up. So make sure that you are receiving notifications for every episode that we upload in the Microsoft Security Channel. See you again next time.